Hi, welcome to the Smart Board. Today I will give you an addition to the MOOC film, and that's dealing with the partition coefficient between the phases. We know that if we have two immiscible fluids, water and an oil phase, and we have a component, let's say A, which is present in the water phase and in the oil phase, this component, depending on the solubility, will go to one phase or to the other phase. And normally, we draw this in a special way by saying, well, let's assume that this is the interface. We draw a vertical line. And then we say, OK, what's the concentration in the bulk phase of this component? Well, let's say that this is the bulk in the water phase. And this is the bulk concentration of A in the oil phase. Then the question is, how does this component divide itself at the interface if there is equilibrium? Well, let's assume that we got here a value C star of component A in the water phase, and here a concentration C star of component A in the oil phase. You immediately see what's happening, because what's the driving force here? You will see that the bulk concentration of A is higher, so in fact there will be a transfer to the interface because there's a lower equilibrium concentration. And here the other way around it will happen. So in fact what we will see is that slowly the concentration in this one will going down to a final concentration, here will be going up. And finally, we will reach the equilibrium after a very long time, an equilibrium concentration which is equal to the partition coefficient, because I want to remember you that the ratio of these two concentrations, this one and this one, was defined as the so-called partition coefficient M. It was defined as CA of the oil phase at the interface, divided by the concentration of A in the water phase, also at the interface. I've taken this definition, but you could also take another definition the other way around. So you always have to take care which definition you take. What I want to say to you today is that this has already been done in the video of the MOOC. And we derived their equation where we said the flux, mass flux, through the interface can be written as the partition coefficient over the mass transfer coefficient of the water phase plus 1 over k over the oil phase till the minus 1 multiplied by, well, in fact, the driving force. But what's the driving force? Is the partition coefficient multiplied by the concentration in the bulk from the water phase minus the concentration in the bulk of the component in the oil phase. You see that in fact this is the driving force. You can see it a little bit. If you multiply this one by m, you will come here and you see that there is a difference between my hand here and the concentration in the oil phase of this component. So there will be a transfer until this value is reached, and if you now multiply by m, you will come up the same level, and there is no concentration difference anymore and no driving force. So this is in fact the driving force. So in fact you could say that this delta C, between quotes, is the driving force which you have. Well, we have seen by heat transfer that we always speak about overall heat transfer coefficients. And how was the overall heat transfer coefficient defined? Phi q was u multiplied by delta t. And the u was composed about the resistances, let's say 1 over u, was composed over the resistances of the different phases or layers we considered. So if you compare this, and you compare this, you can see that in fact there's a quite analogy between these two. Because if we now would write this in another way, you would say M is equal to K multiplied by delta C, you immediately see that this K, the overall mass transfer coefficient, is also similar to 1 over K is equal to M over K water plus 1 over K oil. And you see that this equation is quite familiar, quite similar to this one. In fact, if you take M is 1, they are exactly the same, because this says that is the resistance in the water phase of the component plus the resistance in the oil phase. And so you can make, can see immediately which phase has the highest resistance. And sometimes one resistance is so high that you can neglect the other one. And that becomes that, for example, in gas liquid systems, sometimes the overall heat transfer coefficient is replaced by a small k over L, which only refers to the liquid phase. Well, I hope that you see the analogy between heat, the overall heat transfer coefficient, and the overall mass transfer coefficient. Thanks for looking.